Before we go further, let's revise our all basics. So here it is. Java, our core Java programming is designed for students, for working professionals, and Java is a programming language and platform. Java is a high level robust object oriented programming language. Java was developed by Sun Microsystems in the year 1995 by James Gosling. Is known as the father of Java. Before Java, its name was Oak, and since Oak was already a registered company, so James Gosling and his team changed the Oak name to Java. So before, I'm not going into details, we are revising the main topics here. So features of Java. So the primary objective of Java programming language certain was to make it portable, simple, secure programming language. Apart from this, there were also some excellent features which play an important role in the popularity of this language. So the features of Java are also known as Java buzzwords. So these are the Java buzzwords: simple, object oriented, portable, platform independent, secured, robust, architectural neutral, interpreted, high performance, multi-threaded, distributed, dynamic. These are all the features of Java programming language. So here it all are in detail, you can read it here. So the basic concepts are object, class, inheritance, polymorphism, abstraction and encapsulation. So we already started inheritance. After doing this revision, then we will start from this. So you can read it here. So Java is a platform independent, so it can run on any platform. When you make any program, the Java bytecode with the you can use that bytecode and run Java program anywhere. So reusability. So let's go to Hello Java program. You already know about it. So this is a simple Java program. Parameters used in Java program: class, public, static, keyword, void, main, string, and what these terms are used for. You can read it here. The students who joined in mid of video or who are watching the videos, in mid, so they can see here we are doing a basics. So it's a Java first program, or here are terms, parameters are used here. Class is a keyword used to declare class in Java, and public is a keyword, is an SS modifier which represent visibility. It means it is visible to all. Static is a keyword. If we declare any method as static, it is known as static method. Means fixed, we can't change. So the core advantage of static method is that there is no need to create an object to invoke static method. So the main method is executed by JVM. It doesn't require to create an object to invoke the main method, so it saves memory. Void is the return type of method. It means it doesn't return any value. Main represent the static point of the program, and string args is used for common line segment. So we learn it later. Now you already knew about it. And system.println for printing the statement. Whatever you write in this parenthesis, it will print. So system is a class. So out is the object of printStream. Class println is a method, printStream class. Then here is Java variables. For setting path, and you can see the video, second video, Java tutorial number 2. So variable is a container which holds the value while the Java program is executed. Variable is assigned with data variables, with the data type. Variable is the name of memory location. There are three types of variable in Java: local, instance and static. There are two types of data type in Java: is primitive and non-primitive. So variable is name of reserved area or located in memory. In other words, it is the name of memory location. It is a combination of vary plus able. So you can read it. And types of variable. So let's go to the main points here. So local variable declared inside the body of the method is called local variable. So you can see here. So local variable is declared inside the void method here. In this example. An instance variable declared inside the class of outside body of the method is called instance variable. So this is a instance int data type 50 is a here in this program is instance variable. Then static variable. Variable which is declared as static is called static variable. It cannot be local. You can create a single copy of static variable and share among all the instance of the class. So memory allocation for static variable happens only once when the class is loaded in the memory. So with this example you can understand clearly. Int data 50 is instance variable, static int is static variable, and inside the void method here is local variable. So here are more examples. You can run on your computer the basic questions. Are here, add two numbers, widening, typecasting, overflow, adding lower type. Let's go to Java data types. The primitive data type and non-primitive. The primitive data type include boolean, char, byte, short, int, long, float and double. And non-primitive type includes classes, interfaces and arrays. You can see here. In this diagram, data type, primitive and non-primitive. Primitive is boolean, numeric, and numeric is character integer, and integer is this. And here is floating point, float and double. Boolean data type, and all are, here is a detail of all data types, you can read it here. Now Unicode system. Unicode is a universal international standard character encoding that is capable of representing most of the world's written languages. So Java uses Unicode. Before Unicode there were many language standards. Here these. The problem is that a particular code value corresponds to different letter in the various language standards. So the encoding for languages with large character sets have variable length. So some common characters are encoded as single byte and other require two or more bytes. Solution is to solve this problem a new language standard developed is Unicode system. In Unicode character hold 2 byte, so Java also uses 2 byte for characters. So lowest value is this and highest value is this. So let's go to the operators. Operator in Java is a symbol which is used to perform operation like plus, minus, sum, subtraction, multiplication and division. There are many types of operators in Java which are given below here. Arithmetic, shift operator, relational, bitwise, logical operator, ternary, assignment operator. So you can see here. We already done programs of Java in a previous video. So you can go there and see the programs. Here is the theory. You can understand better. So Java unary operators are incrementing, decrementing value, negative expression, inverting the value of expression. There is a program and you can check there also. But in our video, all programs are good and they are showing output keywords. Java keywords are also known as reserve words. Keywords are particular words which act as a key to code. So these are predefined words Java, so it cannot be used as variable object name. So you can read in detail from here. So let's go to Java if else. Java program to demonstrate the use of if statement. So here is the program and if else statement. Ternary operator, if ladder, and Java nested if statement. Switch. Let's go to switch. So Java switch statement execute one statement for multiple condition. It is like if else ladder statement. So the switch statement works with byte, short, int, long, enum type. String some wrapper types like byte, int, long. The switch statement tests the equality of variable against multiple values. So you can read those important points over here. And practice all these program by yourself. Then for loop. So everything is described here in this documentation. You can go and read. So let's go to break. Break is used to when a break statement is encountered inside a loop, the loop is immediately terminated and the program control resumes the next statement. Continue. After break, if you want, this continue statement is used in loop structure when you need to jump to the next iteration of the loop. Immediately, it can be used with for loop or while loop. A Java continue statement is used to continue the loop. It continues the current flow of program and skips the remaining code as specified in condition. In case of inner loop, it continues the inner loop. We can use Java continue statement in all types of loops such as for loop and while loop. Let's go to comment. Single line comment and multiple line and documentation. Java single line comment. So it is a, this is a single line comment. Java multiple line comment and Java documentation comment. Here are the free programs you can practice. Oops concept, inheritance, data binding, polymorphism. Simula is considered the first object oriented language and the programming paradigm where everything is represents this object is known as the truly object oriented language, and Smalltalk is considered the first truly object oriented language. So the popular object oriented languages are C#, PHP, Python, C++. So the main aim of object oriented programming is to implement real world entities, for example object classes, abstraction, inheritance and polymorphism. So object here is simplifies software development, maintenance, and providing some concepts. And these are design, coupling, cohesion, association, aggregation. You can read in detail from here. Naming convention. Naming convention is a rule to follow as you to decide what to name your identifier, such as class, package, variable, constant, and method. You can read it in detail from here. And here is class, interface. So we will, after inheritance, we will do the programs and package and then interface. Object and class. So these are all real world objects. With the help of these examples, you can understand better. And field, method, constructor, class in Java, field, method, constructor, block and nested class and interface. And syntax to declare here the field is the method, instance variable in Java. The method in Java. Method is like a function which is used to expose the behavior of an object. The advantage is code reusability and optimization. A new keyword in Java is used to allocate memory at runtime. All objects get memory in a heap memory area. So here is a program. You can practice all those programs in your free time. method is a way to perform some task. Similarly, the method in Java is a collection of instructions that perform a specific task. It provides a reusability of code. We can also easily modify the code using method. And what is a method? In method is a block of code or collection of statements, set of code grouped together to perform certain tasks or operation. It is used to achieve reusability of code. We write a method once and use it many times. We do not require to write code again and again. It also provides easy modification readability of code just by adding removing a chunk of code. The method is executed only when we call or invoke it. So the most important method in Java is main method. So here is, you can, it is clear from this picture. So here public is as specify, int is return type, and method is name is sum, and parameter list is this. Predefined and user defined method. Everything is explained here in detail. Then constructor. Constructor is a block of code similar to the method. It is called when an instance of the class is created at the time of calling constructor. Memory for the object is allocated in memory. It is a special type of method which is used to initialize the object. Every time an object is created using the new keyword, at least one constructor is called. It calls a default constructor if there is no constructor available in this class. In the class, in such case, Java compiler provides a default constructor by default. So there are two type of constructor in Java, no argument constructor and parameter constructor. Now come to static keyword. Static can be variable, also known as class variable, and method, block, and nested class. So Java static variable, if you declare any variable as static, it is known as static variable. So the static variable can be used to refer to the common property of all objects. Advantages of static variable is it makes a program memory efficient and saves memory. Program of the counter without static variable is here. Java static method. This keyword in Java. This question always come in exam, and this keyword. And June 2020 also, this question came in exam about this keyword. It's very important. So this is a reference variable, state and behavior of. There can be a lot of uses of Java. This keyword in Java, this is a reference value that refers to the current object, state, behavior, and this. So uses is six uses of Java keyword. This can be used to refer current class instances. This can be used to invoke current class implicitly. This can be used to invoke current class constructor, and this can be passed in as an argument in the method call. This can be passed as argument in the constructor call, and this can be used to return the current class instance from the method. Now come to inheritance. It's a very important topic of Java. Inheritance in Java is a mechanism in which one object acquires all the properties and behavior of parent object. It is an important part of object-oriented programming system. So the idea behind inheritance in Java is that you can create new classes that are built upon existing classes. When you inherit from existing class, you can reuse method and field of the parent class. Moreover, you can add new method and fields in your current class also. Inheritance represents is a relationship which is also known as parent-child relationship. Why use inheritance? For method overriding, so runtime polymorphism can be achieved. For code reusability, terms used in inheritance: class, subclass, superclass, and reusability. You can read in detail from here. It's a Java T-point documentation. So the syntax of Java inheritance is here. Extends is used here. For example, is an employee class and salary and programmer and bonus. These are subclasses. This is main class. You can better understand with this example. Types of inheritance in Java. On the basis of class, there can be three types of inheritance: single, multi-level, and hierarchical. So this is hierarchical, multi-level, and single. Multiple init is not supported by in Java through class, so we will use instead of interface and multiple and hybrid. Aggregation is very important in class. If a class has an entity reference, is known as aggregation. This question always asked in Viva, Project Viva. If a class have an, or in interviews also, if a class have an entity reference, is known as aggregation. Aggregation represents has a relationship. Consider a situation: employee object contains many informations such as ID, name, email ID, etc. It contains one or more object name, address, which contain its own information such as city, state, country, zip code, etc. is given below. Aggregation for code reusability. Code reuse is also best achieved in aggregation when there is a relationship. So inheritance hash should be used only if the relationship is maintained throughout the lifetime of the object envelope. Otherwise, aggregation is best choice. Understanding meaningful example of aggregation. In this example, employee has an object address. An address object contains own information such as city, state, country. In such relationship, is employee has an address. And all these concepts are covered in coming videos. You can read theory from here and programs in my video. If you have any doubt, you can come here and see. And for all programs, whatever you see in my videos, you can go to my GitHub account in repository. Here is a Java tutorial repository. You can see all programs here. All programs. And these are Java interview questions. And here is the playlist. You can go to the playlist and see all videos. And data structure, Java coding, and numerical computing, statistical, networking. There is a videos of networking, core Java theory. You can search, type it here, and all videos will be shown there. There is web development, Python, computer networking, advanced database management, project operating system, and financial accounting. You can go there and see. Thanks for